The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
President Trump, which is still president, by the way, according to the news media, I guess they don't even think he's still in the White House anymore. I know that they're not paying zero attention to our president, which they should. And I guess that's for the people who watch the video on the replay. I'll start saying hello to everybody as you're coming in. And I don't know. I'm not seeing any comments. Let me swipe my phone over. I don't know. It might be me. There's your comments. There they are. We got some people on here, Sean Tucker, Eva, how you doing? We got Pam, Jeff Shanks, how you doing? Maria Dukes, hello Maria. Hope everything's okay. Maria, hope everything's okay. There's Carol, Carol Neal, how you doing, Carol? Don, how you doing? Yeah, I look all puffy, you guys. I almost didn't make it to this live video. I went to sleep. I've been up for the last half hour, man. I hate falling asleep. And that's what I did. Kathy Leedy, how you doing? Yes, I almost didn't make it to my own video tonight, and it's been a boring weekend here for me. It's really been boring. It's been raining here in Ohio. It's been kind of cold. It's just been a nasty, nasty, dull weekend here in the state of Ohio. We got a lot to talk about tonight, though. We do have a lot to talk about. I will be reading comments tonight. I'll be taking some phone calls. Yeah, my voice. I don't know what's going on with my voice. It's like, I don't know. I think I've been yelling too much lately. I need to calm down some, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to calm down, but I haven't even shaved in a while, you guys. But my beard really don't grow on this side of my face where I had radiation treatment. So when I grow a beard out, it kind of looks like a mangy dog. You know, you ever seen a dog with the mange? That's what it looks like when I try to grow a beard out. And I've noticed I was looking in the mirror today, and my chin's starting to fall. I'm starting to get that old man chin where your skin falls. I used to have real tight skin there. Now it's all starting to sag down, and I don't like looking at that stuff. But we're all gonna get old. So what can we do about it? Ain't much we can do about it. Alan Hatfield, there's my friend Alan. How you doing, buddy? There's the Hatchet Man. I'm glad the Hatchet Man's on here. This guy really pumps me up. I like the Hatchet Man. It says Henry Hunter, Hatchet Man Henry Hunter, but it was Hatchet Man. Had another name here a few months ago, Hatchet Man. But really like Lucas. Some or another Hatchet Man. I'll just call you Hatchet Man. That's all right. But, folks, and it's not only watching my videos, but, I would encourage everybody to watch Mark Hatfield, people like Scotty Harris, anybody who gets on here that supports our president. I would encourage you to listen to all these people that gets on here and does these videos. We gotta keep strong for this president. And, right now is not time to be giving up on this man. It's just not time. He has not conceded yet. You guys got to remember, our president has not conceded to this election yet. And I don't foresee him conceding anytime soon. And it is official. I am going to I'm going to be going to the march in Washington, D.C. on the 12th. I will be there unless something happens before then that President Trump concedes or something like that. But I really don't see him conceding because on the December 14th, that's the day that the electors go and turn in their votes to their capitals. And I don't see Trump conceding until after that. They're still got court cases going on where I know that Pennsylvania shot them down somehow. One of those Obama judges in the appellate court shot the Trump campaign down, their legal team. But Jenna Ellis said that helped them kind of, you know, it gets them to the Supreme Court faster. Because time is running out here, and thing is, Trump cannot concede this election. And but the most important thing is this Republican Party right now. They have to stand strong behind President Trump. The Republican Party. I'm talking about all these senators, all these congressmen and women, Republicans. They have to be standing behind our president. a lot of these Republicans, like the governor down here in Georgia, going ahead and letting those votes being certified. That was wrong. That Kemp guy, Brian Kemp is his name, and the Secretary of State was supposed to be a Republican, but they turned on our president. They should at least let him get time to do another recount there, which I think they'll do that anyway. I'm talking about an audit, not a recount, but an audit of that count in Georgia. Well, something happened bad down in Georgia, and you guys know that. Guys, hey, Susan, how you doing? How you doing? Betty Allen, how you doing, Betty? Good to see all you on here tonight. And I know a lot of people's in church right now, folks. I don't go to church, but I do believe in God, so don't down me on that. I hope you don't down me. And here lately, though, before I wanted to get into a lot of this stuff tonight, I want to tell you guys that I've been seeing a lot of stuff come on my Facebook newsfeed. And it's bad stuff about our president. I kept seeing it for like the last week and a half, couple weeks, and it said Trump for prison or prison for Trump or something like that, and I made a comment. I said, how in the hell or why in the hell do I keep seeing this shit on my Facebook newsfeed? And man, I got attacked by 100 of those little liberals. They attacked me like a swarm of bees, and they said I was a member of their group, and I said I am not a damn member of this group. And lo and behold, I went onto this group in Facebook. And I was a member of this group, and I didn't put myself in that group. And it took me like 15 minutes to figure out how to leave the group. And if one of my friends are putting me into groups like that, I don't do that. Please don't put me into groups like that, because all you'll see is the bad shit come out about our president. I don't like seeing that stuff, and I don't think Facebook should let people put you into these groups. And I did not join that stupid group, and I kept wondering why I kept seeing the most horrible things about our president. I kept seeing this shit over and over. And God, did they attack me? I tell you what, it was like a swarm of bees on honey. Man, did they attack me. Just because I said, why in the hell do I keep seeing this shit? And they told me I joined this group. I did not join. That goes against everything I believe in. Everything that I believe in. I did not join that group. And I tell you, I made a post this morning. Listen, here's how people are. I don't understand people sometimes. I made a post this morning. I'm going to stick by this post. I said, Joe Biden and everybody who committed fraud can kiss my ass. That's what I said in a post. And there's two, maybe three people. You guys can go look. Yeah, two people write a comment. Don't give up on President Trump. And I'm like, where in the hell did I say I was giving up on our president? I mean, I don't get it. You can make a post and people automatically assume you're giving up on the president of the United States, and I'm the last one that's going to give up on this man. I'm not giving up on him until he concedes, and I still won't give up on him because I don't think he should concede right now. It's not time for him to concede. We know that this election was corrupt. We know that there was fraud in this election, and he needs us right now. He needs his supporters right now more than ever. He needs the Republican Party to have some balls right now. Now's not the time to be throwing in the towel, giving up, giving in, whatever you want to call it. You got to stand strong behind this president right now. Now, I titled this video, what can you do for your president right now? What can you guys do for the president? I'll tell you what you can do. There's still a few things you guys can do as Trump supporters. You can. There's still ways to help him. First of all, keep posting good things about him, that you support him. Keep your support strong for this president. You write or email your Republican senators, your Republican congressmen. You write them, email them. You let them know that you stand behind Trump, and they better stand behind Trump, too, or they'll lose the next election. Because you are their constituents, and you're the one that puts these people in power. You put them right in their place. Don't you let these people tell you different. You elect these people, okay? So write them a letter, send them an email. I don't care what you got to do. March for President Trump. And if they're marching in your state, or try to get to D.C. and march for your president. But stay positive. Show President Trump that we still got his back. We're not behind him. We're not in front of him. We're beside him. We're right beside our president. We're going through this together. And let him know that. And he does. He knows. He knows. Just like right now, Joe Biden has almost 80 million votes. Almost 80 million votes. And Trump has like 72 million votes and plus, right? And add those numbers up, folks. I've been trying to do these numbers. If you add them both up, I mean, honestly, we only got a population in this country about a little over 300 million people. You tell me that half our population voted this year on November 3rd? Half our population? That's unheard of. There's something happening. I believe that Trump got his 72 million vote plus. But I do not believe that somebody like Joe Biden, who can't even bumble through a sentence, you know, without messing up in a damn sentence, got almost 80 million votes, more than any other candidate in the history of our country received. It'll probably end up with about 80 million votes, and that's a lot of people. And I would call that a lot of stupid people, if that many people voted for him. I doubt it, though, but that's a lot of stupid people, folks. I don't think there's that many stupid people in this country. 80 million people? My God, that's a lot of people. Then you add on Trump's votes. That almost puts us at half the population. You got to think how many people there is under 18 in this country. How many people in this country are under 18? How many adults out there are eligible to register to vote that are not registered? I'm talking, they're in the millions. Something's not adding up, and I know somebody out there is a lot smarter than I am when it comes to math. So please, somebody do these numbers and tell me there ain't somebody in Washington just figuring this shit up. Somebody's got to be out there figuring this shit up, because I can't figure it up. I'm not that good. Once I get past the hundreds of thousands, I start losing track. I'm not very good at adding in the millions, but just figure it up. Come on. We've only got a little over 300 million in population in this country. I don't see more than half the population getting out of here voting on November 3rd. Then you got all the people that's in prison. A lot of those people cannot vote if you're in prison, incarcerated. All the people that's under 18. My God, there's millions and millions of people under 18 that are not ready to vote. They can't vote. They're not old enough to vote. And like I said, all the people who's not registered to vote, then add up all the votes for Biden and all the votes for Trump. It probably is more than our population if you add it up. But I tried, folks. It's really hard to just seriously try to add that up. The numbers just don't add up. And I didn't even graduate high school, folks. I'm not that smart a guy. But you guys, come on. I know there's somebody out there a lot smarter than I am. Think this shit up. Add it up. I'm not receiving my comments. Let me flip this back over again. Somebody, there to go. There goes my comment. Some Rebecca Eves. Biden is a bigot. He sure is a bigot. And he's also, yeah, when Kathy, maybe he, corruption. Corruption is running rampant in this country. The biggest fraud in this country, the biggest fraud that ever took place in this country was on November 3rd, 2020. Biggest scam in U.S. history was on November 3rd, 2020, this year. And I'm not going to give up. I am not giving up on this president, because I know that Joe Biden didn't win this election. And they're calling him President-elect Biden. He's projected to be president-elect. He's not been officially certified as president-elect, even though the weirdo has got the blue wall behind him that says Office of President-elect. Hey, Floyd Croucher, how you doing? My brother from Trenton, Floyd Croucher. How you doing, Floyd? Great patriot right there, Floyd Croucher. A lot of great patriots on here, though. All of you are great patriots. And just for watching me, I don't know. Heck, I'm already getting a phone call. We'll take it. But I got a lot more to talk about. Hello, could I get your first name and what state you're calling from?
It's Hatchet Henry. Hatchet Man from New York. How you doing, Donald?
Hatchet Man, how you doing? Brother, what is your real name? Just your first name. I don't need your first
name. My real name is Larry Lucas Jr., but it's backwards on Facebook because I've been attacked so many fucking ways from Sunday and ain't even funny.
I figured that, because I remember the Larry Lucas part, so thank you. Man, I think you...
I got marked up a while ago by Antifa and a couple other groups for standing for Confederate monuments, and went to a couple rallies and got banged up for that shit too. So whatever.
We're trying to save American history, right?
What spurred me to call you, Donald, is that question you brought up about the 80 million votes.
Right.
Well, they already proved it. That the Dominion system can be hacked. It can flip votes, it can create votes, it can make votes just fucking disappear. If you think for a minute Biden got 80 million votes, you're all fucking stoned. I mean, seriously, fucking stoned. I mean, I want your dealer's goddamn number, because that shit's got to be good.
Right. I don't believe it for a minute, Ash, man. Believe
There's
me.
There's no way.
No.
Look at the size of the rallies. Trump told 50 to 70,000 a fucking rally, like rock stars. You see, Biden, he had two or three cars that looked like a rundown fucking drive-in theater.
Worse.
I mean, come on now. Let's be reality here.
Oh, yeah. I agree totally with you. That's what I'm saying.
All that shit with BLM and Antifa running through the streets and the loot, that was all Democrat paid for, the whole fucking thing. That NFAC group, that black militia, that is a Democrat paid for deal. The leader of it, he's a flop fucking presidential candidate.
Oh, yeah. That's why I was bringing it up, Hatchman. These numbers can't be right. There's not that
They're not
many
right. They're not
no,
right. What you all better pray for is that we get justice and these judges flip this shit over. Because if they don't, I'm just going to say it crude and rude.
Go ahead.
We are fucked. We are fucked. I mean, really fucked.
Well, I could have said it better myself, Hatch, man. Yeah,
I'm sorry to be crude and rude to use though that they use such crude language, but I just can't describe it any other way. They're going to go after guns. They're going after Trump supporters. They're going to hit our ass every which way from Sunday. They already got an online site called that Reputation Defender. Well, guess what? It ain't going to be for you.
The people, they really need to hear that, Hatcher, man, because...
It's true. We're all going to get doxed. If you don't know what doxed is, doxed means they're going to fuck with everything from your homeowner's loans to fucking your credit to your kids at school. You name it. Everything will be fucked with because you supported the right, and Trump.
Right.
This is a serious shit going on right here. They're going to make everybody pay for daring to fuck with their evil agenda. And this is really, truly evil. I'd like you to sit here and say I'm some conspiracy theorist, and it's all bullshit, but you can see the writing on the wall. This is pure fucking evil. It is evil.
I'm going to tell you what, Ant-Man, you're absolutely
evil. This isn't just an opposing party. They want you dead. They don't want to just... They don't want to debate you if you haven't noticed, even at the rallies for the last couple of years. Antifa, none of them. They don't want to debate you. They want you gone. You either submit and be a dog, or they want you gone. That's what you're really facing, people. Me, I'm fucked. I mean, if this shit rolls Biden, I'm fucked. I'll be in jail soon. You guarantee that.
Well, we're dead. I mean, I agree.
Not because I'm going to do anything, just because of what I've already done. They're going to burn me down. Are you kidding me?
Well, sure.
All the people I stood with a lot of bigger names. I mean, Jesus, I'm going to get killed for this.
Yeah, they got, don't think they don't have your name back here somewhere, Hatchet, man. They're waiting to get to you, brother. They're waiting to get you. And I'm not a conspiracy theorist guy, but I'll tell you right now, that's why I've been doing these videos.
You can ask Scotty Harris, you can ask any of those guys that went to a rally, what you see the most of at a rally. You see these sons of bitches running around with what? Cameras. And they're taking photos out the dickhole of you. Every fucking one of you. I can't even tell you how many photos I probably had of me. And you know what that's for? That's for future doxing.
Sure
those
is.
Guys are not your friends, and they're certainly not out to make you famous. Not in a good way.
Well, how many of these people had already said if we win this election, that them, the liberals, the socialists, that they're going to be coming after every Trump supporter? I mean, I believe this shit, Hatchet Man. I really believe this.
Oh, yeah, they are. And they already came out. You see it on the news. They're already talking about docs and White House workers. You know, like that Kayleigh McEnany or whatever. She's going to get doxed there. She's already being attacked.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Oh, man.
But she's excellent, though. I like that. That she's the White House spokesman, right, Kate?
Yeah, yeah, that chick is sharp. I mean, she is razor blade sharp. I mean, no matter what they throw at her, she's always on it. You know, and I've never seen anybody like her. That girl's amazing.
Just, that's why I keep doing these videos. I think to myself sometimes, is people getting tired of hearing me talk? But I don't care. Do they realize, but it's just like you said, I mean, you get me pumped up, man, you really do, but people really, they don't realize that we're fucked, and I hate dropping the F-bomb, I really don't care, but we are fucked if these people take power of this country. That's why I'm doing these videos. Maybe we'll open up some eyes, brother.
I'm just trying to be a Paul Revere myself. I don't want anything from anybody. I'm not looking for any business. I don't want any money or donations. I don't know what I'm saying is I'm not trying to be Paul Revere. I'm just telling you, the fucking Redcoats are coming, man. They're fucking coming, and they really are.
Absolutely, and they're coming in the way of communism, fascism, socialism, and like, you know, I almost don't get mad at me, Hatchman, for saying this, or anybody out there listening to me, but we've got a really lot of stupid people in this country, and I don't like stupid people making decisions for me. I think when you're voting in this country, we ought to have an IQ test before you're allowed to vote. At least you should know some common things about America. To say, like, what is it? Life, liberty, and justice, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness are God-given rights. A lot of people voting today don't even realize what that stands for. Our God-given rights, our inalienable rights. They don't even know that it came from the, what's it came from? Our Bill of Rights, the Bill of Rights, that's where it came from. I mean,
I was just watching some of your comments, and I was watching some of the people saying, like, bring it, you know, I'm like thinking, you know, one-on-one, you know, if they come at you house to house, you're fucked. You're going to lose. I'm going to lose. Nobody's going to be able to beat them. You're going to have to start organizing with your neighbors and the people in your neighborhoods so that if they show up at one house, all of you bunch up at the same goddamn house, and they got to fuck with all of you at once. Instead of going house to house and getting raided one by one, it's better you group up, and you're going to have to start organizing. Everybody's going to have to. If you don't, get on the truck. Just give me a fucking gun. Get on the goddamn truck and don't make a sound.
Well, I've been prepping for years, and I've been telling people in my own way, I'm saying, all patriots, be ready to mobilize. You have.
I don't want to see any violence, but I think if you get enough numbers, you can hold off being arrested. That's what I'm saying. You don't want to shoot any damn police. That's not what we're talking about.
No, and I'm not talking about
killing Americans. Obviously, it's got to be police that come to get you, so the only way to stave them off is with numbers. You're going to have to bring out a shit ton of numbers. Well, every time they try to arrest somebody, that's the only way you're going to be able to do it.
Well, thank you for saying that, because I keep seeing people saying, going to say, well, I don't want Americans to kill Americans. I don't want it coming to that. I mean, that's the last thing I want is Americans having to kill Americans. That's the last thing I want to happen, Hatchman. And
it was said by other people. It wasn't my idea. I'm just going to repeat something. Actually, Billy Sessions is the one who said this one. He brought up a point a long time ago that if a civil war broke out, they're just going to declare martial law, and they're going to shoot both fucking sides, left and right. They don't give a shit. The government is the fucking government. We're in goddamn charge. Fuck you, patriots. Fuck you, we're left wingers. We're in charge. And we tell you to stop, you're going to stop, or we're going to kill all your asses. That's it.
Yeah, they're not going to care about we the people when it comes to that.
That's long gone, guys. That's fucking long gone. I hate to say it.
I mean, you have to be ready now.
That's my soapbox 10 minutes, guys. I appreciate your time, and I'm going to jump out and continue to listen. I do appreciate your love.
Well, I want to hear, I do these videos, I want to hear from you guys. And, Hatchet Man, I want to thank you for calling in. We always love hearing from you. And, everybody else, call in and tell them, Hatchet Man, before you get over here. Tell them to call in here.
Actually, yeah. Give a call, guys. I want to hear you, too. Have a great day.
All right. Bye, Hatchet Man. Have a good one, brother. That's Hatchet Man from New York, and he's telling you the truth, folks. I mean, he's not getting ready just trying to cuss and to scare you. He's not trying to scare you, but this stuff is real. We don't know how you. I know you guys. I'm just talking about a lot of people in this country. It's like they don't care. They don't care. They don't give a shit. I don't know what it is, but they should. They should, because if they wait till it's too late, then it's too late. It's too late. Just like we did come out in masses. We did. Trump supporters came out by the masses. I mean, every vote Trump got, I believe, was a legit vote. Over 72 million votes. That's more votes than any other presidential candidate has had in the history of the United States. I think Barack Obama had the record with 69 million votes. I think that was the 2008 election. The last election, Trump, Hillary Clinton, they got in the 60 millions. Nobody's ever reached that. Nobody's ever went past that 69 million mark. But lo and behold, they've got Joe Biden down for 80 million votes. There's no way that old bumbling man and Kamala Harris got 80 million votes. Hello, can I get your first name and what state are you calling from?
Hey, want to talk Dawn.
What's up, buddy?
Hey, Don, this is John Hand right down the street from me, brother.
What's up, Don? What's on your mind tonight, man?
Well, as we talked before the election, I'm ready to mobilize. I just don't know where to mobilize to.
Hey, where could
That's
you move?
Wrong.
I mean, where could you move to? I mean, Alaska? I mean, I'm not ready to freeze to death. I can't. I'm not an Eskimo. I was thinking about maybe moving to the mountains of Kentucky. Somewhere down in the mountains, these liberals, where they, I don't know, is there any place safe in the country? I don't know, brother. I really don't have an answer for that. I wish I did.
It's not a place, really, I believe. I believe it, like the last caller said, numbers. Numbers is safety.
Well,
you can make anywhere safe if you have the numbers to be on your side.
That's what Axeman was saying. You know, you got to have safety. You're right. Safety in numbers. And, but are people going to stick together? That's the thing. Are you going to see Trump supporters running and say, no, I voted for Biden? You know what I'm saying? I don't know if they would truly stand up and say, yes, I voted for Trump. So what? Bring it on.
Well,
bring it on.
Well, I'll be honest with you. A few of us that will and are don't standing up. People, when they see the S hit the fan, they're going to say, all right, no more of the normal world they want. They want the normal world back. That's why a lot of people voted for Biden. They think that Biden was old and old school and it's going to go back to normal. No, it is not going to go back to normal.
No.
We now know that our vote, we now have no trust in our voting system. We have no trust in our government. And you know, what the biggest thing I think Trump has accomplished for every American in the United States is he showed us how deep that this rabbit hole is, really goes and how much they will do to take us out.
Well,
and
sure.
How much they want to control us.
Well,
and
he
that
said it.
Is the problem.
He said it when he said drain the swamp. He showed the American people just how big this swamp was, how deep this swamp was. And brother, if that swamp has grown, I'm telling you, I think if the swamp has grown, it's been growing. I mean, he was telling you the truth by draining the swamp. And I like I was telling Action Man, I don't get into conspiracy. I never have got into conspiracy theories. Trust me, brother. But a lot of people in this country do not realize how important it is that Joe Biden, this election as it is stands right now, it cannot move forward as it stands because we are literally, and I'll say it again, I hate to say the F-bomb, we as Americans are fucked. Our country is gone. If you won't even recognize America in another six months to a year, I'm ready right now, I'm not even recognizing America today. Almost not recognizing our country today. And I'll tell you why here in a few minutes. Go ahead, I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, that's exactly it, Don. I mean, the toothpaste is out of the tooth. All right. We know, regardless of who gets elected, Trump or Biden, the other side will not accept it. And you know what's going to happen. There's going to be the America of 6 years ago is no more. It's no more. With the virus, with everything they're trying to pull, it's different. The world is completely freaking different. And
it is.
People that want normalcy are the ones that are going to be sitting back watching us go against them, then saying, all right, this is coming to my house. This is coming to my life. Now I see it, and I hope it's not too late when these people start to want to mobilize.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but you just said it right there. You just said it. A lot of people don't care until it affects their life, until it slaps them in the face. And I'm sorry for interrupting. Go ahead. But you just said it right there.
Well, my question to you is, like, where do I go to mobilize myself? You know, because like I said, Hatcherman said numbers are safety.
Well,
now, you're saying Kentucky, Alaska. I'm talking about, man, who do I go to? Because you were talking about the crazy people that you had to deal with a couple years back that you had to get out of an organization.
I belong to a militia. I used to belong to a militia, and I got out of it.
Yeah, and that's what scared me, is your story, because I don't want to be in something, an organization like that, but we need an organization. We need to organize. We need to have people that aren't going to go off the edge, that the only rule of that organization is the Constitution of the United States.
You said it again.
Only rule.
Yes, that's what we have to abide by. It's that piece of paper, the Constitution. That's what's holding us together right now. And just what can we do? What we're doing right now. Look, we've got over 130 people in here right now. Basically, we're all sticking together right now. We are sticking together. There may be a few trolls in here. I don't know. Yeah, there is a troll. Some guy named Alice Watkins. I'm seeing F. Trump. Well, I'll tell you what, Alice. I don't know if you're a girl or a guy. You can say F. Trump now, but wait 6 months if that man doesn't win this election. You're not. You just gave your freedoms up. You just gave your freedoms up. So thank you. Thank you, you stupid person. She is a stupid person there. She's stupid.
Yep. I had to put it out there, Don, man. I mean, everybody has to be mobilized.
Or be ready, be prepared to mobilize. And I'm not talking about going out here killing. We can't kill Americans.
No, I'm not inciting violence.
I know you're not talking about that neither, but I don't know what they're prepared to do to us. That's the thing. What are they prepared to do to us Trump supporters, us people? We the people who believe in the Constitution. That's the problem. You got these people that wants to bring the Constitution down. They've been trying to bring that Constitution down for a long time. And they started way before Trump even got elected. And it almost succeeded under the Obama era. This guy, I didn't trust him from the get-go. And what did we do? We didn't do it. What did the American people do and all these people committed fraud? They put us back in the same position we just got out of 4 years ago. I cannot believe this crap. It pisses me off.
It's worse.
Worse.
It's worse.
Oh, yeah.
It's worse.
They're more radical now. They like the squad. You got them people, AOC and Ilhan Omar, people who hate this damn country. You got people like that that's going to be running the country now. If this election is allowed to go through as it is right now, America will fall. It will not stand like that. And I'm not yelling at you. Trust me. I'm not yelling at you, buddy.
No. I'm fired up, too. I'll be honest with you, man. I mean... It's worse. They're just being blatant about everything, man. They're shivering. I mean, come on.
Oh, the evils came out.
They're just so blatant, and they're not only taught, they're taught to hate Americans.
Well, sure,
America.
Sure,
they're
they are.
Taught to hate America in school. The indoctrination's been going on for years, 50s, 60s, 70s. Slowly sitting that in. Political correctness, controlling speech. You know that all that. It's part of what, if you've watched documentaries of how Adolf Hitler got into power, wow.
Well, you know what?
It's similar to this.
Tell me if you agree with this. I don't agree with anything Adolf Hitler done. I think he was a very evil, evil man. But this party we got trying to take this country over with right now, I'll call them a coup, okay? I feel like as a Trump supporter, I feel like a Jew back in the Hitler days, back, you know, Jewish people back in the 30s, early 40s. That's what they're going to look at us as, like Jewish people. Anybody who's voting for Trump, they're going to treat you like the Nazi Germany treated the Jewish people back in those days. And that was horrible. That was horrible.
Well, they better put a yellow star on my full group vest then.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's another thing. Like Israel. Let's take Israel. I back Israel 100%. Donald Trump is the only president. I don't know. They've all had a chance to move the embassy to Jerusalem. Why did President Trump do it? Why? Because he got things done. He was an effective president. No other president did that. What other president walked across that DMZ line there in North Korea and South Korea? President Trump did. Any other president could have reached out to Kim Jong-un, but they didn't. And we're at world peace right now. But are we willing to give that up? Are we willing to give world peace up right now? Because this utopia that this damn Democrat, Socialist, Communism party's looking for. Man, I don't get it, brother. And I'm sorry to be yelling. I'm not yelling at you. Trust me.
No. Like I said in the comments earlier, man, is that it's a marathon. And I'm only going to sprint when I need to because I'll be out of breath. My nerves will be shot.
Well, I'm a fat guy. I get out of breath easy, but I've got a bug out bag back there. I couldn't even pack. I pack it out to the street. I'm gonna be out of breath. I couldn't even carry it. But I don't want to resort to that stuff. I have guns. I don't want to resort to my guns.
What I mean by marathon is about standing up, man. Right now, he's laying low because I know he's up to something. We just have to wait for it to happen.
Well, sure, President Trump. He's always got the Trump card up his sleeve. But I'll tell you what, this country has been infiltrated. I know about infiltrated, but like you said, indoctrinized. These teachers and professors teaching our children to hate their own country, to burn the American flag. What a crock of shit this is. People are conforming. They've given up. Most of the people in America, they're wearing the mask. They're wearing the stupid shields. I'm not a mask bandit. Trust me. I'll wear them when I'm forced to wear them. But I just don't believe, like, curfews. Don't put curfews on the American people in these states. I just don't believe in that stuff. Government is supposed to play a small role in your life. But now these people, they've cheated some guy in, and this lady. It'll be Kamala Harris end up being your president. But these people, when everybody's lives are completely controlled, when they can't even turn on the television and watch what they want to, you're going to watch what they tell you to watch. They may even do away with Christianity. They may come and confiscate your Bibles. I don't know how bad it'll get. And I don't like scaring people. I'm not for doom and gloom. I'm looking for, hey, we still got a chance. President Trump, we can still hold these people off for another 4 years until he gets more of his things implemented into this country. More justices put on the bench. And there was one of Obama's justices in Pennsylvania that turned him down, you know, for the recount or whatever. It was one of Obama's justices that he put on the bench in the appellate courts. And President Trump has been replacing a lot of these judges. And my God, we needed that man for 4 more years. We need President Trump for 4 more years.
Well, the people on the left right now, and I've talked to, I went door to door, you know, as I was telling you. And I'll be honest with you, and for all the people that read the Bible and everything, it tells you in the end times that evil will blind people of evil.
Sure.
And you see it. They just don't see it. And we see it, and we try to explain to them. They just don't see it.
That's all I can do. As a man, I can say, and you're calling in right now, and I applaud you for I want everybody to call in, just like you did. And anything else you want to say? Because I'm going to give everybody, try to give everybody a chance.
Yeah, you go ahead, man. Go ahead and do your thing, Don. Appreciate you taking my call, man.
Well, listen, you brought up some valid points. I want to say God bless you, and stay strong, man. Let's try to think positive. But it's hard to sometimes think positive.
I am worried about what might happen.
What might happen scares the hell out of me, man.
I know, but we got to take the small victories right now so we don't drive ourselves crazy, Don.
You're right, brother. Well, thank you for calling in. I think there's some trolls in there I got to get rid of. There's a bunch. I don't know. They found me, brother. The trolls have found me. I don't know if they shared me into some weird group or whatever, but I'll take some more calls. But you know one thing before you get off here? The trolls don't want to call. They don't want to tell me why they voted for Biden. They don't have a reason. And I'll talk about
because
that.
Because they don't have their bullet points in front of them, so they can rebuttal anything you say.
Or they're shooting
their
little memes up. They want to shoot these little memes up, these little weird memes. I'm so sick of this meme shit. I don't know. I got a lot of stuff to talk about, but I want to thank you for calling in. I'm gonna give some more people a chance to call in, but thanks, brother. And I'm hanging there.
Yep.
Hang in there.
Yeah, you too, bud.
All right,
buddy.
See you, buddy.
Bye.
Alrighty, somebody's saying I see the F-U word right there. Right off the bat, F-U. I don't know who they're talking about, but my wife's in there. She'll get rid of some of these trolls, you guys. She's in there, and she will. She'll get rid of Kathy Leedy, I've been seeing you. Trolls are pussies. Yeah, that hatchet, man. You're right. Alan Hatfield says, come to West Virginia. Trolls, I'll show you how we play. I don't think they want to come down to your neck of the woods, Alan. I wouldn't want to come down there and mess with those country boys in them mountains. You guys know those mountains, right? That's your backyard, the mountains are. Man, we must have a lot of trolls in here right now, but how the hell did they find me? They've gotten brave. They have. Melissa Helton says, follow here, we go on Facebook. Melissa Helton, that's another person right there. Gonna go. Hello, can I get your first name and what state are you calling from?
Caroline, Ohio.
Hey, what's up, Caroline?
Hey, I just got some news. There's breaking news. Come from DML News. And
that's Dennis Michael Lynch, by the way, you guys. Dennis Michael Lynch.
Yeah, he, anyway, Jenna,
Ellis.
I think her name is Jenna Ellis.
Yeah.
Okay, she tweeted out that Sidney Powell is not a part of our team. She is, has no part of being a personal, lawyer for President Trump.
So what,
all that she is, what she, her claim is, all that she's been saying with no evidence, she won't even give us the evidence. So they are disclaiming her. They're not going to claim her as the team for Trump anymore.
Yes, you know, the media hasn't been. They haven't gave that lady, they think all of us are like a bunch of crazy people. The media does. They really think we're a bunch of idiots. They think, well, they just won't accept the election results, and this election was the most fair election in history. I've been hearing all that, but what do you think, Carolyn? What do you think about Sidney Powell? What do you think about her?
Whenever I heard what she said, I got excited. I thought, oh, wow. You know, they've really got the goods on these machines. But as time went on, when it got to the point where she wouldn't crack out with not even one word, not even to her team, that bothered me.
See,
then when this came out, this only came out about 10 minutes ago.
Really?
Yeah, it just happened. This just happened. That's the reason I left your show, and I saw the alert, so I went and looked to see what it was, and this is what it was. So this just happened, Don.
Well, Dennis Michael Lynch, I like him, and I don't like him. Trust me, I do like Dennis Michael Lynch. He's been a good, sometimes he's negative toward our president, but I liked him back when he was doing his walking talks. And but I've got this Sidney Powell. I've got a video right on my phone here, right here. I could play it where she's telling this news reporter, yes, I have the evidence, but no, I'm not going to give you the evidence I have. I'm going to wait till it goes to the Supreme Court. And she was talking about Georgia at one point, and she says it's going to be biblical. She's going to blow Georgia up. But from what you're telling me, so all this is bullshit, is what you're saying?
Well, what I'm repeating to you exactly what was wrote and exactly what Jenna Ellis, she texted out or she tweeted out that Sidney Powell is not a part of their team.
Wow.
She has gave nobody, she's done them the same way, and they're all supposed to be a team.
Right.
Them the same way as she's doing the mainstream media or whoever she's talking with, Fox News or whoever. She's not giving them any information either.
Well, see, that's
where
what
they can all work together.
You remember when Rudy Giuliani came out, what was it, Thursday, with that team, Jenna Ellis, Sidney Powell, the rest of them? That's what I thought.
Yeah.
Each one of them was playing a role. Each one of them was getting different kinds of evidence. I thought she was like the lawyer in charge of this Dominion, the servers, and all those Smartmatic machines.
Well, I thought she was in charge of the federal end of it.
Right.
And Giuliani and all them was the criminal end of it. That was my take. That's how I divided the team up. But the team is now saying that she's not in the team. That they don't trust what she's saying because she won't tell anybody anything. Now, whether it changed later on, I don't know. But I'm just telling you what just came out.
I believe you, okay, I do, and I used to listen to this Michael Lynch, but he has reported some bad stuff on our president. I will check into this, Carolyn. I will.
Yeah.
I do fact searches, and I just don't take one fact search, one fact checker. I go to like 10 different posts, and I make sure that it, you know what I'm saying? But it's good.
Yeah.
I'm glad you called in and told me that. Now I have to look into this. Now I have to look
into
it.
Well, that's why I'm calling. I'm not saying that. I'm just telling you what he repeated, for Jenna Ellis. I mean, you don't tell somebody on a mainstream media like he's got, his following, you don't go and lie about something that somebody tweeted when all they got to do is go there and look at the tweet.
Well, Carolyn, I do. I appreciate you calling and telling me that, but here in my own belief right now, I hope that's not true. I don't want to believe it, but I will fact check that, Carolyn. I will fact check that.
Well, what it did, it made my stomach drop because there's so much going on, and we're doing all we can to keep our spirits up.
Right.
And watching these people stand our ground and all. But there's one thing about it. I think when things start coming down, if we as American citizens don't all come together like they do, you know, like Stop the Steal and the Million Man March on, if we don't get these people coming together, or for example, what we're living through right now, we've got a 10 o'clock curfew.
Yes.
On full-grown people. I mean, good Lord, I'm old enough to be able to make my own decisions, for God's sake. I've done it all my life, and I'm still alive and won't vote.
Well, that's the bad thing, Carolyn. We've got a damn Republican governor, supposed to be a Republican governor, and he's got us. I'm right here with you. I live in Ohio, Carolyn. You know that. We're in a curfew. I'm 51 years old, and I'm going to get a ticket if I'm out past 10 p.m. I haven't had this kind of crap imposed on me since I've been a teenager. I don't like somebody telling me I can't be out past 10 p.m. But, man, what you're saying is
so.
That's really important what you're saying, and I'm going to have to fact check that, okay? I'm not saying – I know I believe you read it on DML, but please let me find out for sure, okay, Carolyn?
Don't lose hope yet.
I'm going to keep hope. Right now, actually, you guys, some of you guys can fact check that right now. See if what Carolyn's saying, what DML said is true. Please do that, you guys, right now. Carolyn, anything else you want to say before I take another call?
Yeah, I think that it's going to take people here in Ohio to come together as a group against the 10 o'clock curfew that they put on us. I think it's going to take us coming together and just showing, hey, 10 o'clock means nothing. This virus doesn't tell time.
Well, that's right, but right now I would be up there protesting Mike DeWine like crazy right now, but I'm really focusing on Trump right now. I don't really have time to focus on DeWine. This has happened at a bad time here. He's put me in. He's really screwed me over here. I mean, I had to vote for DeWine because I didn't want a Democrat governor. I was forced to vote for DeWine. In the primaries, I voted for Mary Taylor, his the one that was running against him, the other Republican. I didn't want DeWine. I had to vote for him though, to stop a Democrat.
Well, but Carolyn, between you and me and everybody listening, DeWine is nothing but a Fauci by another mother.
He reminds me of George Burns. I don't know. He just reminds me of a small version of old George Burns. Remember him? The movie Old God? Well, anyway,
my mom used to have reruns of that.
I like that movie. Anyway, I don't know. That damn DeWine, I don't know. He's got to go. We'll get rid of him when his time comes. He's got it coming. But right now, my main focus is on keeping President Trump in the office for another 4 years. And we'll get DeWine later, Carol. We'll get his ass
okay.
later.
Okay. Well, listen, I'll let you go, but I thought I'd let you know that news. And I did come on here so people could look it up.
All right. Well, thank you, Carol. I appreciate it. All right.
You're welcome.
All right. Bye-bye.
Okay. God bless.
God bless you, Carol. All right, you guys. You heard her. And she got that all from DML, Dennis Michael Lentz. But I have seen some bad things that man has posted against our president. I used to read all my news from Dennis Michael Lentz, but I got tired of some of the shit I was seeing. And I liked him better before he got his little news app. He was better when he was doing the live videos, the walk and talks. I'm pretty picky on who I listen to. Get another call. Can I get your first name and what state you're calling from?
Austin, Texas,
right?
Yeah, but I'm a Republican. Yeah, it's hard up here.
what's your first name?
William.
William. So what's going on in Austin, Texas, brother? What are you calling?
Not too strict. What's up?
Go ahead. Just tell us. Tell them anything. It's your turn to talk, brother.
Okay. I'm not. I don't know too much of what's going on in our state. I know we work in our city, but I know we want to vote out Adler because he's a damn Democrat, and that's annoying the hell out of us. We're trying to recall him or whatever that is, get rid of him. I don't know. I feel like so. It's kind of hard, you know, out here because we don't have a lot of Republicans out here, but they are out here in numbers sometimes, you know. But they do agree. I'm tired of this socialist ideological whatever from the Democrats. I just our freedoms are being ripped apart. I'm just trying to stay strong and hopefully Trump can somehow pull it out. I just don't know what we can do.
Well, I don't know if you was on there earlier, but listen, do this. I know Texas went red, so God bless Texas. Y'all went red. Just like the state I live in, Ohio, we went red. Well, West Virginia, a lot of states went red, but not enough. Not enough went red, and it was rigged, dude. I believe it was rigged. But what you can
Of course. And here's the thing. The whole Dominion, the whole part about the Dominion software, that it came, and that the person that, whoever designed it is in Germany, right? And that, something about, like, we know it's factual that he actually stole votes from the voting machine. I mean, I don't know.
Well, Biden didn't get 80 million votes. Joe Biden did not get 80 million votes.
No, of course not. Of course not. I agree, he didn't. But what are we going to, be able to do anything in the Supreme Court? Like, are we going to be able to get this done? It better be getting done.
Well, I'm praying, but what you can do right now, what you can do as a Trump supporter right now is call your Republican senator if you got one. Call your Republican congressman if you got one. Show up at these rallies. Keep making the
We haven't had a rally. I would love to have a rally in Austin, Texas. I would host that shit in Austin, Texas. I would hold a rally.
Well, come to D.C. Come to Washington, D.C. on the 12th. Come with us and join us in D.C. and let's march for Trump, man. December 12th? What's that?
Is it December 12th?
December the 12th, man. Go to D.C. and join us.
Oh, I definitely will. I'll have my American flag and I'll be there, bud. I mean, I'll show my support for Donald J. Trump. And just, I just don't know how this all ends for us. And it got me on nerves
everybody's feeling the same way you are right now. I'm telling you.
Right. I know. And when are we going to get the win that we need?
Well,
and put them down.
It may take a while. Now, listen now. Al Gore, back in 2000, Al Gore, George Bush Jr., it went on for 36 days for one state down in Florida. One state, 36 days, 37 days, something like that. We have to let this play out. We're not going to jump into just having a rubber stamp for Joe Biden and, hey, you're the president. That ain't the way it's going to work. It's not going to work
that
way.
Right.
He will be an illegitimate president if we allow this election to move forward the way it is right now.
It's correct.
He's illegitimate.
He is illegitimate. I get it. I agree. I completely agree with you. I just don't know.
Please don't think I'm yelling at you. I just get really mad.
No, you're not. You're not. No, I know that. I know you're not. No, I was just agreeing with you and everything. That's all I was doing. I wasn't mad at upset at your opinion either. I'm just trying to figure out. I'm just trying to figure out how we expose them and how long this comes for the media to finally admit it, and
I'm going to get into that topic right here in a few minutes. I'm going to get into that because there's something I want to say about Joe Biden and the Democratic Party is trying to force upon America right now, and that's something I'm going to start talking about right here in just a minute. As soon as you get off the phone, I'm going to tell everybody about this.
Okay, yeah, I'll definitely, keep the Republican, keep the wave going, keep the rallies going, stop the steal, bud.
Right, we got to keep the energy up. We got to keep the energy flowing. That's why.
Yeah, we do.
Deals, and that's why I think it's Jeremy, I can't think of his name. The guy says, my wife knows his name. Kathy Lady, if you're still out there watching, write my wife and tell her to bring me a wet wash rag because I am sweating. Kathy, if you're still out there, text my wife and tell her to bring me something cold. But there's a guy who does videos. I mean, he's really big. Jeremy something. And this guy, I'm telling you, he's good. Everybody's been sending me his videos. I can't think of his last name, though. He was one of the guys that helped create that new platform, Infinity, that didn't work out right with everybody. But I forget his last name. I'm sorry. I'm drawing a blank here.
It's all good. But I understand, but I was just gonna, it's okay if you don't, remember the information right now, but I was just going to say that, it just got me worried about December 20th and all these electoral votes and what if he has to get out of office, if by January 20th if he...
Now, if President Trump does not concede, if he does not concede, this thing will go to the House of Representatives. That's when the 12th Amendment will be put in play. But I hope it don't make it to that. I hope the Supreme Court can overturn these states and make them go back and audit their votes and take away all these bad votes that wasn't supposed to be there.
Right, I agree. But what if, when do you think the timeline is going to be? That would have to be soon, though. It has to be after Thanksgiving or something, right? Well, it has to be done.
I'm not a professional in the Constitution. It's really hard to understand. But I would say it's December the 14th is when the electors go to their state's capital and cast their votes. You know, like Ohio has 18. We will be casting ours for President Trump. And Texas, you guys are, I think you guys are the second biggest electoral college in the union other than California. Your guys' electors will be going on December the 14th. That's why we're all going to D.C. on the 12th. That's 2 days before the electors go and cast their votes for their president. You know what I'm saying? So December 14th is a really important day for President Trump. Hopefully we can get this done before the 14th, but I think we can push it right up to Inauguration Day, maybe further. Maybe further than Inauguration Day.
I do agree with you. Hey, you know what? I was going to tell you. I like the way you're keeping the momentum going and keeping a positive attitude and trying to keep us positive. But you're better than half of these talk show radios. Talk show radio hosts.
Well, I appreciate your kind words. I do, but I'm just a regular guy that I support President Trump, and I just. I got grandkids. I got four grandkids, brother. I want them. Listen, I've always said I was born free. I want to die free. But most of all, I want our grandchildren to live free. I want them to live free. And these people are not going to push this crap. They're not making decisions for my grandchildren. That's why I'm mad. I'm furious.
I get it. I completely agree with you. I was just going to say that. You know what they did when I told them that, I told the radio host that he doesn't have to leave office if there's no rule of law. He can just stay in office in January and January 20th. And guess what they did? They hung up on me. Hung up on me.
Hey, I got the guy's name. You can go watch his videos. Jeremy Harrell. Thank you, Melissa Helton. His name is Jeremy Harrell. He does these videos, and he says, here it comes, or here it is, or something like that. But watch Jeremy Harrell. Look him up on Facebook. Look up Mark Hatfield. Look up Scotty Harrison. Look at the post from the Hatchet Man. Just stay positive. Keep pumping. Let's keep pumping. Let's keep this energy flowing over President Trump. Let's not give up on him. That man has done everything for us for 4 years. 4 years. He's pumped for us. He's not giving up on us, and I'm not giving up on him.
And I'm not giving up on him either. And a lot of the members are giving up on him. And the Republican Party, Chris Christie, today gave up on him, too.
That's starting to really piss me off. But I'm going to get into another topic.
That pissed me off, too.
Well, thank you, sir. But follow me on Facebook if you're interested. Follow me or send me a friend request, okay?
I will. And I'll listen to what you're – and then you're going to bring up about something. You said the rally is in December 12th?
December 12th. It's March for Trump Part 2, December 12th, Washington, D.C. Be there.
Okay. I will.
Go on my page. Go on my Facebook account. I've got the link and everything put on my Facebook account. My brother, thanks for calling, and God bless you from Texas. And God bless Texas.
And God bless you, too.
Brother. See you. Have a good one. Yeah, Melissa Helton, there it is. Here we go. That's the name of Jeremy Harrell's videos. Here we go. And he's got a lot of good information, you guys. I mean, I can't say a bad thing. I won't say anything bad about anybody that supports Trump anyway. I'll never do that. But, folks, here's what's got me fired up tonight, why I want to do this video. Joe Biden and Nancy Pelosi, the Democrat Party, they're all wanting us. They're all calling for unity. Unity now that they think their guy won this election. Well, I'm going to tell you something. They can go to hell. Them people, the Democratic Party, the mainstream media, and all these people who support Joe Biden and the Democrats and their party, they can go to hell. I'm not unifying behind these people. They have put our president and us Trump supporters through pure hell. For the last 4 years, they have put us through pure hell. Now they want us to unite. Go to hell, you bunch of Democrat bastards. I'm not uniting with you people, you evil people. You put our president through this Russia collusion hoax bullcrap. Then you come up and you tried to impeach our president. That didn't work. And then you did all this other stuff. Now you've cheated this election. I will never unite with you Democrats. Because you sure did not unite with our president, and you never got behind our president. And that's what pisses me off about the Democratic Party. Now they're talking about they're wanting us to unite. Bullshit. That's a lie. That's a smoke screen from hell. You people don't want to unite with us. You've called us deplorables. You've called us Nazis. You've called us every name in the book. I am not going to unite with you bunch of freaks out there. I'm not going to do it. And I don't like stupid people making decisions for me who my next leader's going to be. I'm telling you, these people have to take an IQ test before they're allowed to vote. There has to be something, folks. You have to take a test before you get a driver's license. You have to take a test before you do anything in this country. But the most important thing is electing our leaders, and you can take the stupidest person off the street that has no idea who in the hell they're voting for, and automatically they're allowed to vote. And some people ain't even citizens of this damn country. That's the kind of shit that pisses me off. Never unite with evil. That's right, Susan Haddix. I'm never uniting with that evil. And right now, this is a fight between good and evil, brother. And I'm telling you, we're on the right side. Trump is not the evil side. The Democrats are evil, nasty people. I don't care how many trolls are on there. My wife will take care of the trolls. And Linda, if you're listening, please bring me a wet rag. I'm sweating. I'm talking to my wife, you guys. Kathy Lady, can you send my wife a message and tell her to bring her husband a wet rag? And I think she's coming. I hear her running the water right now. But you guys want to call, the number's at the bottom of the comments. You can call. What's Joey says, F you and F Trump. Well, we got a lot of trolls in here. Wow.
My wife got rid of like 40.
My wife says she's got rid of 40 trolls tonight already. But they're still in here saying F Trump and everything. So, wow. Guys, I'm sweating. I'm telling you, we all need to sweat for our president. We all need to get worked up for our president. We've got to keep this momentum going. We've got to keep the energy going. We've got to show him that we're behind him 150%. Let's not never give up on this president, you guys. Bless the hell. There's been a lot of good comments. I've missed a lot of. Don't get rid of all of them. Let them play with some of these people. Your grammar is terrible. I don't care about my. If you're talking about my grammar, I didn't come on here. I didn't say I was ever some big grammar star. I didn't even graduate high school, so I don't care what you freaks say about me. I could care less what you liberals think about me. All right. I don't care. Like President Trump, he don't care what you people say about him. How many times this man been knocked down? They tried to knock him down, but they've never knocked him down yet, have they? No, they haven't. They're not going to knock him down this time. And you liberals out there, these trolls that are in this feed right now, I'm telling you bunch of weirdos something right now, you're not going to get by with this. The American people, the real American people, will not let you get by with this. Yeah, you've got the mainstream media on your side. Big whoop-de-doo. Whoop-de-doo. We all know the mainstream media is a bunch of liars. They've all been paid off. They've all been... They're just like some of these Republicans, folks. I think they've been bought off, too, by the Democratic Party. Some of these Republicans. God, I wish they was all like Tim Jordan. Here, the congressman from Ohio. Wish they was all like Tim Jordan. It ain't going to happen, though, folks. They can't all be like Tim Jordan. Tim Jordan is my hero. And I'm interested. I had something else to talk about. You guys call in. The phone number is right here, folks. Call in. One of you liberals out there, one of you little trolls, call in. I mean, tell me why you voted for Biden. You can't do it. Hello, can I get your first name and what state are you calling from?
Hi, Don, it's Kathy Leedy.
Well, Kathy,
I'm trying.
Linda says she's trying.
She's got to tell me her name so I know.
I know she is, but I was sending her messages. Thought her Linda brings out a cold rag.
Look, Kathy, can you see? I got my rag, Kathy.
I've seen that you got it. I was over here dying. I'm gonna tell you what. Every time I catch a troll, I just write troll because I'm gonna tell you what. There's no way Linda can keep up with all these idiots.
Well, you know she's under my name, Kathy. But we've got almost 500 people in here, right? We got almost 500 people.
Well, you know what, Mark. gave a shout out for you today.
Mark
on
Hadfield
his video.
Did?
Yes, he sure did.
I caught the tail end of it. And I shared it into my page and my group, but I didn't get the first
one.
Wow.
He sure did. He mentioned you and said what a good, you know, video you put up and everything. You went here and talked and stuff. So we got a ton of people tonight.
Well, I'll tell you what. Mark Hadfield is wonderful, Kathy Leedy, and you're wonderful. Everybody out there, except for the trolls, are wonderful. If you're listening to my voice and you agree with what I say, this just—I'm just an old. I'm not that old, but I'm just an old simple guy. I'm just a simple man telling you what a simple man feels like, Kathy. I can't.
I got it. Did you see my comment I got on there about something about me being old? Does the nursing home know that I have a tablet? By the way, now fuck off.
I like your post. You put up a lot of good posts on Facebook, Kathy, and I try to hit likes on all of them. I do.
Oh, well, thank you, but I come on here, and I'm going to tell you what, Don, I don't give a rat's ass what any of these little pussy snowflakes think of me. I don't care. I'm for President Trump. I'm for our freedom. Fuck the line. Fuck all these trolls. And if you people don't like how I talk or how I think, then you know what? Bring it, bitches. Because I'm 56 years old, I made it this far not giving a rat's ass, and I'm going to make it the rest of the years, too. And if everybody was to stick together, we are truly fucked, exactly like you would have to be upset.
My wife's sitting over here literally with the phone. I mean, I'm seeing so many bad, negative things. Where in the hell these people come from, Kathy? Wow!
I don't know.
Wow!
Under a rock somewhere, and I'm going to tell you what, the sad part is they think we care what they think. We don't.
Hell
we don't
no.
care what they think.
I don't give a damn what these liberal bastards think. I don't call them you liberal bastards. I don't care. I mean, I do believe in God, Kathy, and I don't think God's going to get mad at me for calling them liberal bastards.
No, I don't either, because I'm going to tell you what. If by any chance, which I don't see it ever happen, that Biden would get it, then I want these little snowflake pussy-licking idiots to stand there and tell me how they like being stuck in their houses, how they don't have any jobs, how they're standing their asses in a soup line, wishing they would have thought their shit through a little bit further. I'll tell you, we've all seen poor before. We can make it. But can these little liberal bastards? I don't think so. Can they live on oats? Can they live on beans? Can they make cornbread? Nah, they can't. But guess what?
They don't know what cornbread is. No matter what. These little freaks don't even know what cornbread is. They couldn't live. They couldn't live one hard day in their life. They would have blisters all over their fingers just trying to build a fire. I don't know where the hell these people came from. I must have got shared in some kind of weird group or something. I don't know, but well, there's sure a lot of them out there. But I'm just laughing at them, Kathy. I don't give a damn what you people think. The liberals.
That's how I am.
Supporters. Oh, God.
No, I'm out for the Patriots. The rest of them can kiss my ass. But, yeah, I've been getting a lot of weird friend requests, too. I just delete. I mean, like, I'm getting 10, 12 a day. And then they're adding me into these freaky-ass groups. I'm not joining these groups.
Did you hear me earlier? Somebody had me in this group that they called Prison for Trump, and I didn't join that stupid group. I didn't join
it. I was in it, too. I didn't either. So what they're doing is they're going on our pages, find their friends or whatever, or they watch our post or whatever, and they're joining us into these groups, so they shouldn't be allowed.
My wife is over here. She's just going crazy on this phone. Oh, my God. I don't know where these people come from. But see, Kathy, these people are trying to make decisions for our children's future, and that's what pisses me off. But, Kathy, how come all these people are watching this video? Linda, don't get rid of all of them. I want to hear from some of these people. How come they won't call in, Kathy?
Come on, Anastasia, Alexa. You must be talking about me. I'm the trailer trash. Bring it, bitch. I'll show you fucking trailer trash.
Oh, gosh. I don't know where they come from, man, but what? My wife says she can't keep up with it. She's over here. She cannot keep up with these weirdos. They're coming out like they did. I don't know. They were coming out like they did. They mailed their votes in. All right. These are the people who mailed their votes in. You know.
It's like cockroaches. You know what I mean? It's like cockroaches. They all come out at night. Well, they can come out and have the fun all they want. But Linda, please don't try to keep up with it, because girl, you have carpal tunnel by the time you're done.
Let them go. We'll ignore them, right, Kathy? We will ignore these cockroaches.
Yeah.
There.
Well, it's not. We don't care what they say. If nobody replies to them or anything, we just quit replying altogether.
Let's ignore these freaks. A lot of them's got these Muslim weird names anyway. You bastards ought to be glad you're living in the United States, in the greatest country in the world. You weird little freaks, and you don't understand what's getting ready to happen, but that's enough.
Uh-huh.
I'm not giving them no more attention. That's it. But
Nope. Because I'm going to tell you what. The only people that would ever vote for Biden are people that are willing to hand their children over to a pedophile. So that just kind of makes me sit and wonder, are they pedophiles themselves? Is that why they want Biden in there? So they could have all their little white dogs, little kids? Well, let me tell you something. I ever see a pedophile around a kid, I don't give a damn who you are. You're out of here.
Oh, yeah, I don't even care if you're a Trump supporter. I catch a pedophile messing with a kid. I'm going to blast him. I'm not with my
uh-huh.
I'm talking about with my fist. I'm not going to
put
I don't like pedophilia. And I'm not, you know
what? I don't either.
I just heard Joe Biden say so many weird things, and I've seen so many videos of the man sniffing little girls' hair. What kind of a man does that to little kids? But, you know, that's even beside
the point. Right, baby.
Listen.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
The child trafficking and shit, people better wake up. Because I'm going to tell you what, where they've been all their lives, they've been living under a rock or what they've been doing. But Trump is the only one that's going to keep us free, is going to keep our rights and keep us safe. And everybody better unite. Because I'm going to tell you what, we all need to stand united. That's what they're trying to do. They're trying to work the blacks and the whites and the Mexicans and everybody else, no matter what color, race, or whatever you are. They're trying to divide us all. As long as everybody stays united, we got to speak.
She wasn't talking to Kathy. Anastasia said she wasn't talking to you, Kathy. Linda just told me to tell you that. And Floyd, I'm going to take your call next, Floyd. Floyd's wanting to call in. Kathy, anything else you want to say, Mrs. Leedy?
No, I'm sorry I told you off that you called me trailer trash, but hey, I'll take that as a compliment any day. It's not for me to be a liberal.
Linda said to tell you that she said she was talking about the other trolls, Kathy, and I blow up. I take it wrong. I take some comments the wrong way sometimes. I do.
Oh, I do too. And sorry about that, but hey, I thought I was getting hammered by a troll, and you know me in my mouth.
You've heard me before on here, but you, Kathy, I've mistaken people a lot of times.
Oh, me too. But hey, you guys take care. Love the show. Love you guys. And I ain't leaving. I'm going to be here watching. Call in, Kathy, you guys, and let's get...
Stick around. We love you, Kathy. God bless you, okay?
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye, Kathy. All right, Floyd Croucher. It's time for you to call in. If you want to call in, Floyd, the number's open, brother. Call in, Floyd. Get this phone here going. Yeah, Floyd, call on in, brother. You said you just want to call in. Anybody call in. I'll take the next caller. It doesn't matter. I will check on this Sidney Powell thing, but all righty. Did I get your first name, and what state are you calling from? I hope you're not a liberal.
I am calling from Trenton, Ohio. How are you doing today, Donald?
I know you're not a damn liberal, Floyd, so what's up, brother?
Hey, I just want to touch base on what you said in the... That's not funny.
What?
What you were saying earlier.
Oh, God, I forget, Floyd. I get on these rants, and I can't remember everything.
So have I now. I forgot what I was going to say. You were talking about people voting for people and they don't even know who they are.
Right.
You're not kidding. When I was out there on election day, I'm out there working the polling place, passing out slate cards for people that don't know what slate cards. Most of them don't even know what a slate card is. Yeah. It tells you if you're a Republican, all the Republican is on the ticket.
It's on your ballot.
You got a Democrat. Yeah, just on your ballot, just like the Democrats. The Democrats have everybody that was on that ticket that was running from their district representative to their state senator to the congressman. Yeah, everybody on up your ticket, it was on your party affiliation.
Right.
They had no idea. Out there that day, I was working. There was a Democratic lady out there, and the people could not, once they put the name with the face, they didn't want to vote for. They had no idea until they looked at the individual, which they didn't even look at the policies they stood for.
Well, they don't.
They just looked.
Or did
they vote
care,
for names. They don't even know. They vote for a name and that party.
You're right.
People don't even look that stuff up.
No, they don't. And Floyd, I mean, you gotta understand where I'm coming from. I'm not trying to be mean to anybody. I just think that people ought to educate themselves a little bit before they go in those voting booths and they vote for somebody who's gonna take their rights away. They ought to be a little educated, Floyd, and I dropped out of high school, but I know good versus evil. I know what evil is, Floyd. I know. And you ought to be able to take an IQ test, some little IQ test before they let you register to vote. And I'm sorry if that offends somebody, but that's the way I feel.
I truly believe that people should be educated, at least educated, about who they are voting for before they vote.
Absolutely.
Some people vote, they vote for a name that may have been in there for years and years and years and years, and never will look up the person that is running against them. They're just running against the name.
And they don't know policy. They don't know these people's policy. They don't care. I think they just go along with the crowd. Hey, I'm going to vote for Joe Biden because, hey, my friend says he's going to bring peace and unity, and he's going to build back better. He's going to build back better. Well, I got news. Ain't nobody going to build back better than President Trump. He's already been building back better, you freaking morons.
Well, the money they sucked out of our military, President Trump's already put back in tenfold.
Yeah, but
our military would not be today if it wasn't for President Trump.
Well, Floyd, if they push this election through, as of right now, what's going on right now, if they push this through on the American people, you know they're going to take that money back from the military. They're going to take your Social Security money. How are they going to pay for this new Green Deal and all this other bullshit that they're wanting to implement? Folks, they voted and they cheated for the wrong guy. I'm telling you, Floyd.
Well, it's all going to come out on the 13th. We're going to find out.
Well,
Floyd, we'll find out by then.
I know you are a true patriot, Floyd, and I want to say God bless you and thank you for calling in. You're always more than welcome to call in, and I'm always I always like hearing from you, Floyd. You know that. I am your friend, buddy.
No, yeah, same here, Donald. You're a great patriot, but you did touch on a great subject when you started talking about people just walking in there not knowing who they're actually voting for.
Right.
Most voters don't even care if they put a name with a face.
I watched it, Floyd. I've been thinking about this all day. How did this happen? I know they cheated, but you still got the ones, just like we're talking about, that went to vote and entered a precinct. They didn't know a damn thing about any candidate. They just filled in a candidate or pushed the button. I voted. Well, you voted probably for the wrong person, you weirdo.
Well, if you go and look at your county precincts, what your voter turnout is, every presidential election, go back and look through the years. Now, I understand there was a great get-out-the-vote campaign on both sides this year. Well, I know especially on President Trump's side there was. Because we worked it, Donald.
Well, sure we
worked. You cannot tell me 35% voter turnout increased in one county?
Oh, wow. Boy.
No.
Add the numbers
38%
up.
Voter turnout percent? It's impossible.
Floyd, they've got Biden at almost 80 million votes right now. Floyd, we only have 300 million, little over 300 million in this country population. I'm not a mathematician, but figure those numbers. And you put Trump's votes on there, you're at half the population almost. I know half the population didn't get out here and vote this election. It doesn't happen. And plus, Floyd, here's another valid point before I want to tell you while you're on here. When people start at the top of the ticket, that's your ballot, top of the ticket, if you vote for Trump, right, you're normally going to vote red all the way down. So how did so many people this year skip Trump, vote for Biden, and vote red the rest of the ticket? That happened this year. A lot of people went red all the ticket except for the very top. They went blue. What happened, Floyd? What happened there? Some cheating happened. Some corruption.
Well, they could be a John Kasich supporter on that behalf. I couldn't tell you.
I'm back to Kasich. By the way, you guys don't know who John
Kasich
is.
What a loser. You talk about, I mean, our great president calls, you know, a loser when they need to be a loser. What a loser.
Well, that's true. Like,
that man is a true loser.
Well,
you could go back to that. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say on that. It doesn't sound right. It doesn't look right.
No, it doesn't.
But then again, I'm not a Kasich supporter, so I got my common sense.
All right. Well, Floyd, I'm going to take some more calls. I want to thank you for calling in, brother. You have a good one, Floyd. We love you, man.
Donald, you're a great patriot. Thanks for taking my call.
We got to stick together, brother. We're in this together. See you, Floyd.
See you, Dom.
All right, bye-bye. All righty, that was Floyd Croucher, one of my personal friends. I've been out here. We worked hard together for President Trump here in the state of Ohio. Ohio did go red. And I'll tell you guys, I had this here written down. I didn't have it written down. I share things over my messenger so I can tell you guys so I don't have to write it down, right? I'm going to tell you about Ohio. Well, Ohio. I'll just tell you Ohio. Ohio became a state, I think, in 1803. Ohio's had 55 elections in our history. The state of Ohio's had 55 presidential elections. We have sent 45 presidents to the White House. Ohio, you tell me we were wrong this year? No. Can I get your first name and what state are you calling from?
Hey, man, my name is Kevin. I'm calling from Georgia.
Kevin from Georgia. What happened? Did the devil come down to Georgia, Kevin? What happened down in Georgia? Please tell me.
Oh, hell, man. Well, you heard all about it. I'm sure you heard all the corruption and everything with that pussy-grabbing traitor of a president, Donald Trump.
Oh, you're gone. You're gone.
You're a sodomite.
You're gone. All right.
You're a sinner. You're a sinner and a sodomite.
Listen, I got to get... Listen, you come on here with false information. There you're gone. There you're gone. All right. There he's gone. This phone, I hate my wife's phone. I hate this phone. Now somebody calling. That guy right there automatically wanted to go into some kind of weird shit about our president. Don't come on here and start cussing my president. If you want to call in, you liberals, if you want to call in and treat me with some respect, I'll treat you with some respect. But if you get on here and you start talking shit, I'm going to hang up on you, okay? That's all I'm going to do. You come on here talking bad about our president after what Joe Biden's done? Come on, man, get real. Joe Biden is a fool. He's a babbling idiot. Come on, he gets on here and says, well, me and Barack, we are blubbering around now. I don't even know what blubbering out means. You can't even get a translator to translate Joe Biden. I'll tell you this for the American people. I don't know what ma-ma-ma-ha means. This guy, he cannot serve as president, you guys. But you guys are more welcome to call in. The number's down there. Don't call me up bashing Trump. Call me up. Tell me why you voted for Biden, not for your hatred for President Trump. I don't want to hear that. That's a cop-out. That's a cop-out. Can I get your first name and what state are you calling from?
Hi, Donald. My name is Elaine. I'm calling from California.
Hey, Elaine. How you doing from California?
Pretty good, except listening to your show just makes me sad.
I'm making you sad?
Yeah. No, just listening to all of it. It's kind of like, I would say, a little bit of an obsession for me now. It's like I spend all my free time just going into Facebook and seeing, what there is to listen to update me on the news. And every time it just makes me sad. So people tell me, my friends tell me, well, you just have to quit doing that, just meditate, relax. But they just like, I want to know more and more. Okay, so he was here.
Are you a Trump supporter? Do you support Trump?
Yes. I absolutely do, yes. And I am actually, I'm from...
From California, you support Trump, and I've seen a lot of that out there. How do you stand it out there, living amongst all those liberals that's in California?
Well, I just have to tell you that up until, the whole coronavirus thing started, I was not into politics at all. And, I voted, I'm an American citizen, and I've been for probably 5 or 6 years. So I voted a lot of times. Yeah. Sure. So, since I mentioned this, I will tell you that that's the one thing that I tell people, my friends on Facebook or in real life, I tell them, when was the last time you lived in a country Russia or Cuba? Well, if never, then your opinion is not, I'm telling this to my liberal friends, then your opinion is just not valuable to me. Because this utopian idea of, everybody being equal and this and that and free healthcare for all, this is total bullshit. And I pretty much lived a good part of my life in Russia, or in the Soviet Union, actually. Yeah, I lived in the Soviet Union up until I was a teenager when it fell apart, so I have my first-hand experiences, and so, yeah, so that's another reason why it's so painful just seeing, people's minds transform, really. I was thought that only Russians were so gullible and so, so was so able to be just misled by the so-called leaders, but it's just amazing to see how in just a month, two, and people just turned up in a way.
I'm sorry about the cutoff. People were trying to call in while you're talking, so you actually lived under communism in Russia when Russia was a communist
country. I did. Wow. Yes, I actually did.
Well, God bless you. God bless you, and thank you for becoming an American citizen. And you know what? You got more sense than a lot of Americans do, the ones that were born here. I mean, I will applaud you.
That's good to hear. Thank you, Donald. Yeah, and you know, it's a lot of Americans, so you don't really know history, never traveled much, other than maybe Cancun. So
right.
It's like, what do they really understand? Seriously, like you were saying, as you said, I suggest that maybe history says, you know what I mean?
Right.
It's mandatory.
Well, hey, listen, everybody's trying to call in. Listen, I want to thank you, and I'm going to say God
bless
you.
I appreciate it.
I'm glad you know what's going on. These people that live in America, half of them, they don't know what's about to happen. You do. You came from. You lived
it. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you for your support.
God bless you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye.
All righty. Hang on now. I was getting all kinds of calls. I don't know. This phone was messed up, you guys. Hello. Can I get your first name and what state are you calling from?
Yeah, my and I'm calling from North Carolina.
And what was your first name? Because somebody else is trying to call in right when you're talking there.
My name is Fred. I'm calling from North Carolina.
Well, Fred, you sound like a supporter to me, brother.
Well, I am. But that guy who called in from Georgia, he needs to get beat in my face with a sack full of naked pears.
Yeah,
I don't know what to say about him.
Attacking me? I don't even know what he started attacking our president. I don't even know what he said. I mean, he reminded me of Joe Biden or something. Wow.
They might want to save their tears for when Trump is the elected president of the United States.
Fred,
that is a fact.
Thank you for saying that because the media acts like he's not even there in the White House anymore. They've been written him off like he's not even the president.
Well, the media can say what they want, but the numbers will never lie.
You see,
in Nevada, Trump will win Nevada. Clark County, 168,000 votes will be disqualified thanks to their county commission. You can't disqualify part of the ballot and not all the ballot.
You're right.
When you get into Michigan, he'll win Michigan. Two counties in Michigan alone had more votes than the population of their counties.
Wow.
It can't happen.
That's like Philadelphia and Pennsylvania. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you can look at
it
county. If you look at this country, county by county, the whole country looks red. You just see small little sections of blue. This small section,
well,
and those people run
absolutely.
It's madness.
And I get it. Those are big cities that are blue, so I get how it works. No problem. But in Pennsylvania, their state Supreme Court stepped out of line, so the U.S. Supreme Court will step in, and almost 700,000 votes will be null and void.
Oh, gosh.
Trump will take Pennsylvania.
So that appellate court judge that denied the Trump team.
Yeah, Elise. He will. They're going to have to hear it. The Supreme Court will hear it. That won't be a problem. Their state law says any vote received after 8 p.m. on election night is not valid.
What?
Period.
Yeah,
these people had all this time to mail these votes in.
you're absolutely right, and thank you for bringing it up because the governor just can't say that. You know, we're going to do that. It takes the legislative branch of that state to make that law. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
They think they can just do what they want to do. These Democrats do, and it pisses me off, man, how they act in this country, brother.
Well, we've got one of the smartest presidents we've ever had, and to the point to where in 2018, he actually signed an executive order where it addressed foreign interference in our elections as well as fraud and corruption. It's almost as if he's seen this coming.
Oh, he did.
Forty-five days after the election, there's a report that has to be handed to him, the Secretary of State, as well as the Department of Justice and the FBI. And my question is going to be, who's the fall guy? Who's going to take the rap for all this? Because the algorithm that was used in Dominion, I mean, a kindergartner could have figured it out. For every vote that was given to Joe Biden that he actually got, they put in 1.75 on the tally. And for every vote Trump got, it went 0.75. And they've got the evidence.
Dang.
Our soldiers went in Germany and seized every server, every laptop, everything in Dominion headquarters. We have it all. We have it all, and that's why they're panicking right now. You don't hear Joe Biden speaking or anything. Even Facebook took him down as president-elect and put him down as a politician.
Well, you know, you asked.
You know, we're talking treason.
You said, who's going to pay for this? I'll tell you, it's just my opinion. I hope they all pay for it from the bottom down, from the bottom up. I hope every one of them gets arrested and charged with treason. And in America, when you got charged for treason back in the old days, the death, the penalty was death, brother. You should never meddle with an election. That's our country you're messing with. That's the whole United States. We are the beacon of this world that this country is. What are they trying to...
Well, on the law books today, the only penalty for treason is to be hung.
It's still death,
but only one method. It's to hang them.
Well,
the period.
That's what we
do. And there's no plea bargains to it or anything. And that's what needs to happen. And you can start with Barack Obama, little Miss Hillary Clinton, and then you can go on down to Nadler, and you can go on down to Nancy. I don't care how far you want to go down, but they tried to sabotage this president from the moment he won that election.
Well, you know what?
He's been sabotaged. They spied on his campaign. They've committed so many frauds, it's not even funny. So many felonies.
I got to ask you a question, Fred. How much further do you think they can stretch Adam Schiff's neck, though? That dude's got a neck a mile long, and I just don't know if you can hang a guy like Adam Schiff because his neck's so long.
I think I could rip it off with one hand.
I'd like
to wring his little neck.
Yeah, I agree. I'm not inciting violence, but that little pencil neck geek has made me sick for so long. And now, what do you think about Fred? They're wanting to unite. They're wanting America to unite now. Let's all be happy and love one another now. But they were just burning cities down here a month ago, and now they're wanting to unite.
Brother, no matter who sits in that office, if it's Trump, the left is going to have a civil unrest. That's honesty. If it's Biden who sits in there, the right's going to have a civil unrest. The only way you can prevent this from happening is to press federal charges of treason and lock these people up and show evidence to the American public. Other than that, there's going to be a massive uprising in this country.
Well, Fred, can I ask
you know,
you
no
question?
Matter how we look at it.
You seem
yes, sir. You
seem like a very intelligent guy. Let me ask you a question. Here's what I've been telling everybody. You tell me if I'm wrong or not. I could be wrong. I've always been, because everybody's been saying, well, if Trump wins, oh, God, they're going to burn the country down, which is probably true. But I think if he...
They're going to try.
I think if he wins, if he gets reelected, I think he'll have the military out there in like 10 seconds flat within an hour. He'll stop this shit. He couldn't do it.
Because
he was in election year. You know what I'm saying? They would call him a tyrant. You know what I'm saying? So.
Well, I think you're right. You're absolutely right. He filled a campaign promise. We're bringing 28,000 troops home from Afghanistan.
Well, that's
and we're bringing more home from Iraq. And it's not a coincidence that this is happening right here after the election.
Well, can I ask you a question?
That's not a coincidence.
Another statement. You got Mitch McConnell from Kentucky, right? He was on there bashing our president for bringing these troops home. And didn't President Trump campaign in 2016 about bringing our troops home? So what's up with Mitch McConnell? Has he turned his back on our president?
No, I don't think he's turned his back on the president. I think that Trump has too big of a hill to climb, and he's still trying to save face and save his own ass as far as his political career. But the truth be known, these Republicans need to get fully behind Donald Trump and say enough is enough. But we don't only have... You know, Democrats that are corrupt in this country. We've got Republicans that are corrupt in this country. That's why I voted for Trump the first time. He's not a politician.
You're right.
I don't need to see that man's tax returns. I don't care. He was a billionaire when he got there. Why don't you show me Adam Schiff, Nancy Pelosi's, and even Mitch McConnell's tax returns, who got filthy rich in office when it was dirt floor poor when they went in?
Well, you know,
so how did you do that off $120,000 a year? Somebody explain this to me. I want to see their tax returns.
Fred, you need to start doing your own videos because you're bringing up some very, very good topics here because, I mean, I've been talking about this stuff. Believe me. Like, let's go to President Trump's tax returns. They've been harping on his shit for 4 years. And you're right, I don't care about his tax returns, but everybody misses the main picture here. If Trump did anything wrong on his taxes, and everybody fails to catch this, the IRS would have done had him in trouble. The IRS hasn't said anything. So
you're absolutely right, because when he filed bankruptcy back in the late 90s, he lost $1.2 billion in a fiscal year. There's a law on the books from the IRS who says, if you lose $750 million in a fiscal year, you don't have to pay taxes in 20 years. The man used their laws against them. They made the laws.
You're absolutely
correct. It's not his fault.
You're right.
They made the laws, and now they want to sit and bitch and moan about it. But he just used their laws.
Well, he even said
that's all he did.
You remember he told Hillary Clinton that in the debate. He says, I'm just using the laws you guys gave me. The loopholes. Why not use them? And Fred, you mentioned these guys going in there and coming out rich. You know, President Trump went in there worth like $5 or $6 billion. He's going to be the only president in history to go in and come out with less than he went in with. You're right, Fred.
I understand.
Wow, you're awesome.
He didn't need this, my brother. He was filthy rich going into office. He did this. He could have stayed and lived his multi-billionaire lifestyle. You know, when he gets out, he'll go live that lifestyle.
He
doesn't need all this. And I'm wondering, at what point in time does this man stand up and say, look, I'm trying to do the right thing, and I'm just tired of it. And I hope to God he doesn't, because he's gotten us this far.
Well, you know what, though?
You know,
if he did then in the future, you know, next month or so, I kind of wouldn't blame him. I kind of wouldn't blame him. The hell.
I couldn't blame the man.
He didn't deserve that. He deserved praise and stuff from the people of this country and the media. But what have they done? They've done nothing but put him through pure hell when he's put us first. He's put this country first, unlike any other president in the history of this country.
Absolutely. And on my last subject, I'm going to say George Soros, one of the wealthiest men in the world, it's going to be dead broke in about 6 months if Trump don't get out of office, because with this and everything he's financed with Antifa and BLM and everything else he's done, he's led this Dominion stuff. He owns Smartmatic. There's no doubt about it. He owned that software. They're going to seize all his money and his property, and they're going to try that man too. It's not just people in office. It's people out of office that's going to have to answer for this shit. There's no doubt.
You're absolutely correct. There's a guy on here named Billy Bice. I went back. He said, under Trump, we had no wars. And he's right. Under President Trump, we've had world peace. And have you got any credit for that? No.
First time since Reagan, we didn't start a new war. And on top of that, look at the peace treaty that was signed in the Middle East. They said it couldn't be done.
Trump did it.
And on the Gaza Strip, we've got peace.
How many times you hear about ISIS before you get over here? How many times now are you hearing on the news about ISIS and all this? You don't. It's almost non-existent now.
You don't, because we destroyed them. His first 2 weeks in office, we went ahead and in Syria, we just went ahead and bombed the hell out of ISIS over there and didn't kill a single civilian.
There's some great comments.
Got no credit for that either. Instead, he got ridiculed left and right. CNN, you know, if anybody goes back and reads this executive order, I mean, even CNN's going to have to answer for what they've done with false propaganda. They said the man was racist. As soon as they said he was racist, every other news media picked it up. The Democrats picked it up. All it took was one person saying it, but nobody can prove it whatsoever. But I can prove you Joe Biden's a racist.
It's in his record. I mean, you can go back and find racist remarks.
I can tell you, I don't think Clarence Thomas, our Supreme Court, Chief Supreme Court Justice, Clarence Thomas, I don't think he forgot what happened to him in the early 80s when Joe Biden stood up there and said, quote, now I'm not a racist, but quote, something about we don't need niggers on the Supreme Court.
You know what?
I've heard that. That come out of Joe Biden's mouth on the Senate floor, and I don't think Clarence Thomas has forgot about this.
No, and I think Clarence Thomas is a very good, he's a great Supreme Court justice. He's great. Unlike Roberts, I don't trust Justice Roberts anymore. Chief Justice Roberts, he's been going the way of the liberals, and I don't like that, man.
Absolutely, and unfortunately for us, we really don't need him right now. With the way we zoned it out, if you looked at the new zones that was given after a new Supreme Court justice was put on the bench, you have to divide up the zones. And the way it's divided up, if you look at it, we got a conservative judge over every one of these states that are in question.
You're right.
And I'm loving it.
Now, see, I don't
This
really...
has been strategically placed for a while. It's like you've seen it coming.
Well, Clarence Thomas, he's got Georgia right now, right? Clarence Thomas does.
Clarence Thomas has Georgia, Elise has Pennsylvania, and I don't want to misspeak, but I think it's our new justice that has Arizona and Nevada.
Comey, Amy.
Over there. Amy Comey Barrett.
And we got Neil Gorsuch, we got Kavanaugh. And
then Kavanaugh has Michigan, I believe. But I'd have to look back at the map. I might have them a little mixed up. But over every one of those states, one of our new judges has it.
Well, I think that's
over there.
I don't fully understand how the court system works. Trust me, I don't. I don't have answers for everything, but.
And I don't either. I didn't even know that until a couple of days ago. I seen it and then I researched it and I was like, wow, this man's a genius. I can't believe he just put in place everything he did. And the executive order that he signed in 2018 was almost like he seen the future of what was going to happen with Dominion, Smartmatic, and all these Democrats trying to steal the election.
I'll never quit saying that. I do believe God chose President Trump, maybe that's it. Maybe God put some wisdom in him, and
I think God's using Trump. I think God's using Trump as a wedge, you know, for a little bit more time, you know, is what I think. The man's there for a reason, and I don't care what the man, who it is, but I think it'll be a Trump that wins in 2024 also. And if I laid money on it today, I'd bet my house and the whole family farm on her.
Well, Fred,
I think she'll be your first woman president.
Well, Fred, I'm going to say God bless you. You've been a wonderful caller. Please, Fred, I've never heard you before. Please follow me on Facebook or send me a friend request. Will you, Fred?
I'm about to. I just caught your show for the first time this evening, and I thought, you know what? I'm going to call in. I got something to say. Because everybody needs to know that this, I will, because this election is far from over. Until December the 14th, there is not a president elect. And if it doesn't go through on December 14th, Congress picks on January the 1st. And everybody in Congress don't get to vote. One delegate per state, and there's more red states than blue.
There you go.
That's all I can say on that. And so we'll see which way it has to go, but Trump will stay.
All right. Well, Fred, thank you, and God bless you, sir. Thanks for calling in. And, again, send me a friend request. Don't forget, all right, buddy?
Yes, sir, I won't. God bless you, too.
Have a good one, brother.
You too.
All right. Man, what a good caller. I mean, we've had all these callers have been good callers except that one weirdo that called me. All he wanted to do was argue, but, man, that Fred guy, he was good, and I've been seeing some really good comments go by, and I am so sorry I haven't been able to read them all. And you guys, I've been trying to read your comments, and I know there's some bad ones on here, but I'm not even looking at the bad ones. I'm looking at the good ones, and I'm sorry I can't read them all. Hello, can I get your first name, and what state are you calling from?
Hi, this is Michelle from Georgia.
Hey, Michelle from Georgia, how you doing?
I'm a little irritated and aggravated and everything else with all this mess going on down here.
Well, you're not alone, Michelle. You're not alone. So.
It's a big mess, and you was talking earlier about the devil comes. She did, and her name is Stacey Abrams.
Oh, gosh. That's that lady who ran for governor here a couple years ago during the midterms, right?
She still thinks she's governor.
The one that would not concede. Remember, Stacey Abrams would not concede. That fat ass thought she had that job as governor. She lost.
She still thinks she's got it.
I'm not a big fan of Stacey Abrams. I'm not a big fan.
Me neither. But I do have a quick question.
Oh, I can answer.
All last week, I have been getting phone calls every day last week with someone. They're calling from an Atlanta number. They're asking me about the election. They're asking me who I voted for the Senate, you know, for Congress, for president. Are they allowed to do that? Are they supposed to be doing that?
Listen, that's private. That's between you, all right? That's your business, who you voted for. And no, the Board of Elections is not supposed to be asking you, because if it was from the election officials, they would know who you voted for. And no, don't tell. You don't have to tell anybody who you voted for. That's between you and God, Michelle.
Well, that's like I told him, I ain't none of that damn business, and hung up on him. But I did save the number, and it is the same number that has been calling me.
Well, don't answer him and just block him. I'd block him. And I was going to say something. Your governor down here, your Republican governor, Kemp, boy, was he a big disappointment or what? I mean, certifying those...
He sold us out.
I think the Democrats got something on him. I think they got some dirt on him. These Democrats are good at that stuff. You know what I mean? They're either, what the hell happened? Like I said, did the devil come down to Georgia? I don't know.
From the information that I've been gathering and looking in is that our Secretary of State and Kemp from the Dominion somebody got paid.
You live in a red state. You don't live in a blue state. Trust me. Georgia's, they went red. I mean, you lived in a red state. Pennsylvania was a red state. You guys got screwed. I tell you what, if I was in Georgia right now and I was a Trump supporter, I would be livid right now. I would be so mad. I would be joining those marchers down there in Georgia. I'd be joining them.
They had a wonderful march in Atlanta on Saturday. It was wonderful.
I've been watching. I've been keeping up with that. And the people of Georgia are doing a good job. And you guys don't give up down there. Keep fighting. And come to D.C. on the 12th. Come to D.C. on December 12th and help us march for Trump.
I sure wish I could, because I'd be right up in the middle of it. But, you know, I take care of my elderly mother-in-law. She has dementia, and she's bedridden, so I take care of her. But, you know, it's just, I'm just really confused, because, I mean, the county that I live in, Biden, he only got, I think it was 1,247 votes out of my county.
Wow, that's...
You know, we blow him away here in my little county, but, you know, I live right next to Chatham County, and Stacey Abrams was here for the whole week before the election, and for 4 days after the election, she was in Chatham County.
Well, again, don't get mad at me, and everybody else out there, don't get mad at me, but I'm going to say about Stacey Abrams, I'll say it again, I do not like that fat-ass woman, I can't stand her.
Nobody in Georgia likes...
It ain't got nothing to do because...
And that's what nobody voted for.
Well, I don't like her.
But another thing that I was going to... it was kind of an odd thing that happened right here in Savannah. I don't know if you had seen it on the news. Where they had found voting machines on the side of the road right here in Chatham County. Well, there were several voting machines, which the Secretary of State said they were out-of-date machines, but they were out of Fulton County. They were from Fulton County.
Well, let's just hope that the Trump legal team brings all this up to the Supreme Court. That's what I'm hoping and praying. Anything else you'd like to say, ma'am? Anything?
No, that's all I had to say. You know, I wanted to ask that quick question, you know, are they supposed to be calling you and asking you them kind of questions?
No. Don't tell nobody who you voted for. That's your business, ma'am. Don't.
Well, it don't matter because I'm for Trump.
Well, God bless you, and follow me on Facebook.
God bless you, and keep up the good work.
Thank you, ma'am. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Well, you have a great night.
All right, you too. Keep watching. All right, bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.
All righty. All right, can I get your first name, and what state are you calling from?
Ohio, and I'm Ricky Simonis. How you doing, sir?
Well, what's up tonight, Ricky? What's on your mind, brother?
Well, Brad, I was just sitting here thinking about all this bull crap, and I don't understand. Yeah, and I don't understand how. Who gave them the right? I know there was a pandemic. Who gave them the right to change the way we vote in the middle of a presidency?
Brother, you got me. You're talking about in the middle of the night they quit voting, then you wake up the next day and all these thousands, hundreds of thousands of votes appear on the board. Yeah, that's messed up. That's a good question, though. I don't know.
Yeah, that is. Yeah, that's against our Constitution. He was a president. He asked them not to do that, and they did it anyway.
Well, like Fred said, President Trump seen this coming when they started talking about mail-in ballots in some of these states to all everybody's house, and Trump knew this was bad. He knew this was going to happen. And
yeah, you know what's gonna happen. Yeah, everything Trump said has happened so far. So yeah, you know what's going on. He's
still our president, though.
He's ahead of these people, man.
Who is that? Your wife in the background?
Yeah, that's my fiance. Yeah, she loves Trump.
What did she say?
She said he's still my president. He'll always be our president.
I'll tell you what, he's still my president too, and he will be. I will never, and I'll tell everybody watching, I will never accept Joe Biden as my president if this gets pushed through. Because he will be a rubber stamp illegitimate president. I won't call him president.
They'd have to kill me, yeah. I ain't gonna accept him.
I'm not like these snowflakes. I'm not telling nobody I'm leaving my country. This is my home. This is my children's home and my grandchildren's home, as well as yours. I'm not leaving this country. I'm not leaving.
That's right, brother. That's right. We'll stand together.
I'm here for the fight, brother. And I'm not talking about hurting nobody, but I'm here for the fight.
No, that's right. They want to bring it, they can bring it. Yeah.
Bring it. Bring it on. We patriots will prevail.
We have the right to defend ourselves.
We do, sir. That's our Second Amendment, our Constitution. And that's something that they're trying to take away from us. And that's what these idiots don't understand, all these trolls that are on here. They don't understand that. They're willing to give their freedoms up. Why in the hell would any God-fearing American be willing to give up their freedoms is beyond me.
Right, and they don't know what, the laws is to keep the criminals out of your houses. They don't know what's on the other side of that door.
Well, that's the only thing.
If they know there ain't no guns, then they're going to come in. Yep.
What about defund the police? Boy, that was a dandy. Defund the police. Now,
yeah, that turned out to be a tragedy, didn't it?
It's disbelievable. I'm still shocked by that statement. Defund the police. I'll never know. But anything else you'd like to say? Ricky from Ohio.
No, I think your friend requested. Yeah. All right.
Well, thank you, and God bless you, sir.
God bless you, too, buddy.
All right. Thanks for calling in, man. Ricky from Ohio. All right, buddy. All right, now somebody else can call in if you want. The phone line is open. If not, how long have I been on here? Shoot, I don't know. I started around 6, I don't know. Heck, but anybody else want to call in? Because I'm telling you, I'm not going to be bullied. I'm not going to let these people take me over. I am going to fight back. I'm going to talk it out with force. Might have to, I don't know. But hopefully we can do this peacefully. As far as Trump goes, it's not conceding. Folks, it's not a rule. It's not a law that President Trump has to concede. It's just something that they do. I forget the word. Shoot, it's tradition. That's it. Conceding to the next president is a tradition. It's not a rule. President Trump does not have to concede, folks. There's been a few presidents not concede. Can I get your first name and what state are you coming from?
Hey, Donald, just from Williamsport.
Williamsport, what state is that in?
Pennsylvania.
Well, my name's Donald, too. Well, hello, Donald from Pennsylvania. And what the hell's going on in Pennsylvania? Donald, come on, explain it to me.
It's Jeff. Jeff from Williamsport.
Oh, you said your name's Donald. Jeff from Williamsport. What's going on in Pennsylvania, Jeff? Tell me.
Williamsport, home of the Little League, Donald.
All right. So what happened? You tell me what happened in your state, Jeff.
We have no clue. Home of the Little League, but home of the Big League fraud.
Big League fraud. Well, I think Philadelphia happened to Pennsylvania. That's what I think. I think there was too much corruption in one city there. Philadelphia and probably Pittsburgh. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But you guys always vote. Like Ohio. I mean, I don't remember back when Pennsylvania didn't vote the same as Ohio. You guys had to go red this year. You know that.
Yeah, we're definitely red. Definitely red.
Just like the lady who just called from Georgia. Like her, I'm going to tell you, if I was living in Pennsylvania right now, I would be livid right now. I'm livid and I live in Ohio. We went red and I'm still livid.
Oh, we're livid, all right. Yeah, livid. Yeah. Let's just hope it gets to that Supreme Court soon, Donald.
It's got to, brother. It has to, the Supreme Court, or let's get it to the House of, let's get it to the House of Representatives. But don't freak out because the Democrats run the House. I'm sure you know about the one vote, the 12th Amendment. So we still got a couple options here. It's not over for Trump, folks. It's not over. And
no, far from over. Far from over.
Just maybe, Jeff, the Supreme Court can go back and say, hey, you know, it's easy to have these runoff elections for senators. Why in the hell can't we have a runoff election for a president if they can do it for
exactly.
a senator? I don't understand that.
Exactly. Well, just keep the faith, Don. I'm not going to tie you up too long. I'm glad I got through to you. Or spend some more time maybe at a later date, one of your other videos. But just got to keep the faith.
Oh, I do, bro.
Pray.
I'm glad you're keeping the faith. Keep the faith in Pennsylvania. Keep the faith
it's hard, you know.
Country.
It's hard. We got to rebuke the devil. Just rebuke the devil.
Well, did you hear the lady call in from California? She called in from California, and I've seen a lot of people out there waving Trump flags. I think it was today or yesterday in California. So,
right.
And another thing, Jeff, before you get over, I'll tell you, the night of the election, right when California, Oregon, and the state of Washington closed their polls, it was instantly, they said, California has gone to Joe Biden. Oregon has gone to Joe Biden. Washington, Joe Biden. They didn't even count any of the votes before they said Joe Biden won those states. It's bullshit, man. Bullshit.
Right.
I'm sorry for using bad language. I apologize to everybody, but I can't help it. I'm pissed, man. I'm pissed.
No, it's okay. You can use the F-bombs. It's fine. We're all upset here.
All right.
So just hope for the best. Hope for the best. Prepare for the worst.
Prepare for the worst, brother. And that's right. And well, right now in the state of Ohio, you can't even find ammunition. You can't even buy a gun right now. They're all sold out. But anyway, thank you and God bless you. Thanks for calling in, brother.
Well, pretty well armed. Pretty well armed, Donald.
I've been saying years. I've been prepping
ammo's
for years.
Ammo's hard to come by. That's a hit or miss. But
somebody's coming here. Lee DiPontio. Hang on there. Donald, it's not over till you hear the fat Democrat lady sing Trump got this. Thanks, Lee. Well, anyway, is there anything else you want to say, buddy?
No, just keep up the good work, Donald. We'll be watching your videos.
Well, thanks for calling. I appreciate it. All right. Thank you.
God bless.
God
stay
bless
safe,
you.
Don.
You too, brother.
All right.
Keep fighting.
Bye-bye.
All right. Bye-bye.
Will do. Right.
See you, man. Bye. All righty. That was another Trump supporter from Pennsylvania. Got his name there wrong at the beginning, but when you do these videos, I like I'm sweating right now. You do it. You can't remember everything. I got so much that I'm trying to think of at one time. When you got almost 400 people in here you're talking to, and you got to remember all this stuff. But, man, look, I can sit here. I can complete sentences, but the thing is, I'm not running for president. I wasn't running for president. You had a man named Joe Biden that hid out in his house. I don't know the hell he's in his basement. But the man didn't even get out of here and campaign. And the media is saying he's got almost 80 million votes. That is bullshit. You guys know that's bullshit. He didn't have... Look, President Trump, you guys got to disremember all those rallies President Trump did. One guy, he didn't have no guitar players. He didn't have no drummers. He didn't have no singers. One man attracted all those people and all those rallies. And like that one caller said, Joe Biden would have a few rallies, have a few circles down, maybe 30, 40 people, some people blowing their horns. Ooh, now come on. He did not get 80 million votes, you guys. I will never believe that. Can I get your first name and what state are you calling from? Hello? Hello? Alrighty, I guess you don't want to talk. Alright. I'll go ahead and hang that one up. But you guys call in if you want to. It's up to you. If not, I'm going to get ready to end this video. I've had fun tonight. I've seen a lot of weird comments. I've seen a lot of great comments, but I've seen a lot of weird ones. I don't know where they came from tonight. The liberals are getting brave right now, folks. They think they've got this country. And their little peanut brains, they think they've got this, alright? I don't know what they think they've got. Or where they think they're going, but they're heading in the wrong direction. I can tell you that now. Here's we get another caller. Hello, can I get your first name and what state are you calling from?
From California.
What's your first name?
Carmen.
Carmen from California. Are you a Trump supporter from California?
Army?
Are you a Trump supporter from California?
Of course, all the way. I've been in Republic for the over 50 years.
Well, you know what? You're the second caller from California tonight that supported President Trump. So what's on your night? What's on your mind tonight, Carmen?
Well, right now, I'm in South Carolina visiting my daughter because of the COVID-19.
Okay.
So I have applied to a empty ballot, and I haven't had any news if my vote went. I went to the post office. I put the envelope because we did it to the internet. And I put in a priority mail with the date. And they did. I called the post office. They did get it. But it went to a P.O. box.
P.O. box. Your absentee ballot went to a P.O. box in California, right?
Correct. And I'm totally baffled because is it still in the P.O. box or they just threw it away? And in the envelope that they give you from the internet, we printed, I put the date from the post office. And the reason I was, since I'm visiting my daughter here, they forward my mail. So I called the post office in Orange County, and they said that the absentee ballot cannot be mailed, which I understand. So at that point, I was kind of late because I wanted to vote. I mean, it was very important to me. And also, what I want to say is California, especially in Orange County, San Diego, and the south part of California, there are a lot of Republicans. We just were the silent majority.
Well, you pretty much have to be the silent majority in a state like California. You pretty much have to be silent. But I did see a lot of marching, and I seen a lot of rallies for Trump out in California on the news. I did see that.
Yeah, and then one of my friends that is still, you know, he lives there. I live there, but at the moment I'm not there. He said it was amazing. He did a rally, and it was amazing how many people. And this is one thing I will never, never understand. Trump worked very hard. A lot of supporters, they were there in the rain, waiting for days just to be there. And Biden, he was on his basement, not knowing when he did a rally. Luckily for him that he had 20 people in there.
Right, that's what we
never knew. Never knew which state was in it. Forget about everything. Unbelievable. How can that man have all those votes? This is something really, really bad. And our president, he's the best president we ever had, ever, ever.
Absolutely. Anything else you'd like to say? And listen, I'm just, everybody's trying to call in, and I appreciate you calling from California. I want to say God bless you, for one, for voting for President Trump. And but call
one more thing. One more thing I wanted to say. I came from a country that it was a socialist, communist country. It's the most horrible thing. What is happening right now, they want it closed again because of the virus for 4 to 6 weeks. By that time, people's going to lose their home. And this is what we're experiencing. Right at this moment, it's communist, socialist country.
What state?
Right down how it feels.
What country did you come from?
From Chile.
From Chile.
I've been here in the United States for over 50 years.
See, I want to commend you again because, like I said earlier, there's a lot of Americans that don't even understand what communism is. They don't understand what they're voting for. You do.
Yeah.
I had another person call me. I've had callers from Cuba, all over, Russia. They're telling me, I mean, I knew this, but these other people, they just, Americans, don't understand. People that were born in this country, that's lived here their whole life, they don't get it. They don't get it. And I guess they don't care to lose their freedom. So you're right, and thank you for calling in.
You're very welcome. God bless you for what you're doing. And we're going to win this thing.
Let's win it. And God bless you too, ma'am. And call your Board of Elections when you get home and make sure they got your vote, your ballot.
Well, who do I call? That's what the question.
Well, here in Ohio, every county has a Board of Elections. I don't know what it's called in California, but somebody has to take care of your county's election results. So call who's ever in charge of your election results, wherever you live.
Okay.
I don't know what your
thank
county.
You so much.
All right, you're welcome. And God bless you, ma'am.
God bless you as well.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All righty, folks. You heard it right there. See what it's telling me. I've had these people telling me that they actually lived in communist countries. What is it, though? What is it about some of these American people that want to live like Chile? They want to live like China? They want to live like Cuba? They want to live like the old Russia? I'll never be able to wrap my head around it. Yeah, Kenny Horsley, that's my cousin Kenny. There's been a lot here tonight. Kenny, I don't even care. My wife's got rid of so many of them, they're coming in like rats, cockroaches. We can't get rid of the trolls tonight, but I don't care. I don't care, Kenny. My cousin's on here. Thanks, Kenny, for watching my videos. I appreciate it. James Wright, Trump 2024. I'll tell you another thing, folks. Just like Mark Hatfield. Listen, I really look up to Mark Hatfield, another guy that does videos from West Virginia. He's a direct descendant from Devil Lance Hatfield. But he was even telling you guys this morning that if this election goes through, there will never be another election. So I keep seeing Trump 2024. There will not be a Trump 2024 if this election is allowed to move forward. Kimberly Brooks, I was going to read your comment, Kimberly. Kimberly Bellamy Brooks, they think they will get everything free. You're right, Kimberly. You're right. That's the mentality these people have. They're looking for that free health care. They're looking for that free college tuition. Alan Hatfield, see what I got rid of a message. Hang on. Somebody called my phone. I declined it. Never mind. I got rid of a message from all these trolls tonight, laughing my ass off. Alan, you get these trolls. Take care of them, brother. My wife's been, she's been doing her best to get rid of them. Larry Clark, losers. I hope you're talking about the left, Larry. Nisha Hyde, Barbara, Cynthia Patterson, all you thieving Democrats suck. Yes, you're right, Cynthia. Wade Winters, stand up for the, it's going by so fast. I'm sorry, you guys. I can't read the comments, but, I think I've been running my mouth long enough tonight, folks. I'm getting tired. I'm wore out. My voice is about to go out. I got to get up in the morning and get some stuff done. But anyway, I'm going to get off here. God bless each and every one of you out there. God bless you. And even the liberals, God bless you. You're going to need it if this election goes forward. You better think about what you did. Think about what you did. And here in about 6 months, it's going to slap you in the face what you did. And I know there's still some liberals on here watching, but when you start losing your freedoms, don't come crying to us Trump supporters, because we tried. We tried to save this country, but it's not over yet. But I'm saying, if this election moves forward the way it is, don't come crying to us Trump supporters. God bless everybody that's watching me. Hey, Scott Walter, how you doing, buddy? It's Brian Worth, Claudia, how y'all doing? Wilma Hearn, Trump, no, Trump didn't lose. He ain't finished. Another troll. But anyway, God bless each and every one of you. God bless America. Let's pray for our president, folks. Let's pray for that man. He needs our prayers right now. He needs them bad. Let's pray for our troops that are all around the world right now. Let's pray for them. I know Maria Dukes, God bless you too, Maria. I can't say enough to you, Maria. You've always said that to me. God bless you. And when somebody says God bless you, I have to say it back. But anyway, you all be safe. Be kind to one another. And keep the faith. Don't give up on our president. With that being said, this fat man's all here. I don't care what you liberals call me. See you later. I'll see you in a few days. Bye-bye, you guys. Have a good one.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. You're gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.